What is good, everybody? It's Ross. Kendrick Lamar just dropped an album, GNX, and the internet is going crazy right now. I'm freaking super excited because you know, we all thought he was gonna drop like right after like the height of this beef, but it didn't happen. And so we're all thinking, most of us are probably thinking, oh, he's going to drop it during the Super Bowl time. I mean, that makes sense. And then he just dropped this out of nowhere on 11/22/2024. You know, so anyway, people are having a good time. I'm about to re-listen to this, man. And we're just going to get this. We're gonna really just make this shit go, man. Let's go. We're just going to start with this first song. And Whacked Out Murals.
I watch him pander with them back.
Siento aquí tu presencia. La noche de anoche. Y nos ponemos a llorar.
This intro is dope. This intro is dope as hell. I don't know what she's saying, but it sounds dope as hell.
Yesterday somebody whacked out my mural. That energy will make you niggas move to Europe. But it's regular for me, yeah, that's for sure. The love and hate is definite without a cure. All this talk is bitch made, that's on my lord. I kill them all before I let them kill my joy.
That's a dope ass bar, I'll kill them all. Before I let him kill my joy. That is dope. That's a dope ass bar. And you can never go wrong with strings. For a song, for an album intro, you can never go wrong with strings. Like, I was just thinking about this as I'm working on my own project. Like, strings just makes everything huge. It makes it big. It makes it like theatrical. And so he's already going at her next. Like, he's coming. He's already swinging. He already knows what's up.
With all what you endure, it used to be fuck that nigga, but now it's plural. Fuck everybody that's on my body, my blick first, then God got me.
He's on his demon time right now. He's on his demon time. I feel like, man, yeah, he's on demon time right now.
I watch them pander with them backhanded compliments. Put their head on the Cuban link as a monument. I pay homage and I'll always mind my business.
He's doing this now. He did that in one song with the shoe, with the black Air Forces, which is crazy when you think about it. Like, he got black Air Forces in this, and then he's really on some black Air Force energy right now. And but he bleeped out like what he was gonna say. Like, he's about to say, like, he said something so disrespectful that they can't even approve it to be on platforms. You know, like, we can't even listen to it. That's how disrespectful he's being. So I don't know if he's actually saying something super disrespectful, or like it's just like a thing that he's doing. You know, like, just fill in the blanks just to make it sound even more disrespectful than what it is. Anyway.
So I am for a rap image. Here's motivation if you wonder how I did it. Yeah, nigga, going up your rank. Know you a god, even
okay,
when
got
they
that
say
bass.
You ain't. Yeah, nigga, keep your feelings out the way. Never let no one put smut up on your name. Yeah, nigga, keep your head down and work like I do. But understand, everybody ain't go like you. Yeah, nigga, if they say it's love, you been lied to. A couple rules of engagements, I'ma guide you.
This is nice. Yeah, I'm feeling this.
La noche, tú y yo.
Riding in my GNX with Anita Baker in the tape deck. It's gonna be a sweet love. Fuck apologies, I wanna see y'all geeked up. Don't acknowledge me, then maybe we can say it's fair. Take it to the internet and I'ma take it there. Miss my uncle LeMaine, he said that he would kill me if I didn't make it. Now,
yeah, that bass, that I was waiting for the snare to drop, but I think that's really nice. You can tell he's gonna build the beat up.
possessed by a spirit and they can't take it. Used to bump the Carter 3, I held my rolly chain proud. Irony, oh. I think my hard work let Lil Wayne down. Whatever though, call me crazy, hey. Everybody questionable.
Let's go, he said whatever though. That's what's up. He don't give no fucks. He does not give any fuck. He's pretty much paying homage to Lil Wayne, but at the same time, he's like, man, I guess I disappointed Lil Wayne. All my hard work is disappointing Lil Wayne. Like, ain't that crazy? You know, I'm sure, like, you know, Lil Wayne's been around for a minute, you know, so just think about, like, you know, bumping Lil Wayne in high school, right? And he's like an inspiration to you. And then you blow up, you know, like years later, you blow up. He's still someone you look up to, you still respect. And then, you know, Lil Wayne on stage crying.
That moment I said to myself, I want to be on stage for the Super Bowl one day in front of my mom. And I worked my ass off to get that fucking position, and it was ripped away from me.
That he couldn't perform in the Super Bowl in New Orleans, you know, like, and not wishing you congratulations, you know, not really trying to pass the baton, you know, to the younger generation. There is none of that. And so Kendrick's like, man, I guess I disappointed him. Fuck it. You know, like, let's keep it going. You know what I mean? So, dope.
But irony, I think my hard work let Lil Wayne down. Whatever though, call me crazy, everybody questionable. Turn me to an Eskimo, I drew the line in decimals. Snoop posted, tailor made, I prayed it was the edibles. I couldn't believe it, it was only right for me to let it go.
Okay, let's go. Oh, let's fucking go, bro. Taylor Made is one of the most disrespectful ass songs, like, ever.
The music that's jammed off for real thugs.
Like, one of the most disrespectful ass songs to do to an artist that's passed away, to use AI, use your voice and get a Tupac verse to diss Kendrick Lamar. It is the most disrespectful thing. You know, that alone might have just pissed off Kendrick to the next level. Like, he was like, he's coming, and he ain't letting off. And so I just love that.
Boys, I couldn't believe it. It was only right for me to let it go. Won a Super Bowl and I'm the only one. Congratulate me. All these niggas agitated. I'm just glad they shown their faces quite.
He said, Nas is the only one to congratulate me for the Super Bowl. Ain't that something? Ain't that, like, think about that. Like, for him to say that. And now I think about, you know, I didn't hear Big Sean, J. Cole, like, Jay-Z. You know, you don't hear all these people, all these artists, celebrities, you know, really bigging up Kendrick like that for this. And so, you know, to say that, like, to really just shout out Nas, you know, someone who's from the East Coast too, you know what I mean? Like, that says a lot. So, you know, who knows what's going on in Kendrick's world, but it's definitely, like, you know, it's a 20v1. It's a 20v1 right now. This is a real 20v1 happening in real time.
Plenty artists, but they outdated. Old ass flows trying to convince me that you they favorite. This is not for lyricists, I swear it's not the sentiments. Fuck a double entendre, I want y'all to feel this shit. Old soul, bitch, I probably built them pyramids. Ducking strays when I rap battled in the Nickersons. Where you from? Not where I'm from. We all indigenous. Against all lies, I scribbled up for them dividends. Against all lies, I showed up as a gentleman. I done lost plenty friends, 16 to be specific. Put that on my kids. Children, we go see the future first. They like that big trip, and I just
this cadence is really nice. Like, he's not, like he said, he's not doing anything crazy, any double entendre. He is just making us feel it. Like, you can feel the grit. You can really feel the grit.
What I deserve, what bridge they done burned, all of them is over with. I'm doing what COVID did, they'll never get over it. Yeah, nigga. Going up your rank, know you a god, even when they say you ain't. Yeah, nigga, keep your feelings out the way. Never let no one push mud up on your name. Yeah, nigga, keep your head down and work like I do. But understand, everybody ain't gonna like you. Yeah, nigga, if they say it's love, you've been lied to. A couple rules of engagements here to guide you. Niggas from my city couldn't entertain, no boy. Promising bank transactions and even Bitcoin. I never piece it up, that shit don't...
What? wait a minute. Hold up.
No boy. Promising bank transactions and even Bitcoin.
I'm weak as hell, bro. I think this dude is saying... Because he's talking about Drake. Still talking about Drake. I love this. I was afraid that he was just going to do a whole album and not mention Drake. Dude is disrespecting Drake in so many different ways. I love it. I'm here for it. We want this. Yes, we want this shit. He's saying that Drake... I don't know if y'all remember, if y'all were tapped in during that time when Drake was trying to get information about Kendrick. They were promising to pay people in cryptocurrency. That's what he was saying, in Bitcoin. Drake was promising people Bitcoin. He's promising people cryptocurrency for information. That is freaking hilarious. That is fucking hilarious.
Never piece it up. That shit don't sit well with me. Before I take a truce, I'll take them to hell with me. If that money got in the hands of a crash dummy, could jeopardize my family and burden the ones who love me. Niggas mad cause I decided not to pretend. Y'all stay political.
This is my face right now watching this. This is the energy right now you gonna get. This is the energy. This is the energy right here. You just... What the... This motherfucker's spitting right now.
Correct, I'ma do what I did. Ain't no sympathy here. This shit's hilarious. It's a lot of opinions, but no power to carry it. 2025, they still moving on some scary shit. Tell them quit their job and pay the real niggas they severance. Don't insult my intelligence. I'm not just for the television. Teleport the bullets rolling, dig up.
Yo, these synths are crazy right now. These synths are crazy. Like, any producer right now, like, first track, it's dope as hell. It's different. It's like, it's West Coast. It's like New Age West Coast. It's like a horror film, thriller movie, you know, like happening. Like, it's just the ambiance, the vibe. It's like, man, dude, I really love synths, bro. I'm a sucker for synths, especially synths like this. Man.
Relatives, okay, nigga, let's settle it. These niggas been fake loyal since y'all pandering to choose a side. Let me do it for you, okay? Fuck your hip hop. I watched the party just die. Niggas cackling about, but all of y'all is on trial. Niggas thought that I was antisocial when I stayed inside of my house. You better off to having one woman. Everything tricky right now. You niggas live.
That's a bar. What? Whoa.
Social when I stayed inside of my house. You better off to having one woman. Everything tricky right now.
You know that's facts. That's definitely facts. Something I'm definitely appreciative of. Something I'm definitely appreciative of is, like, you know, I'm not out here in these streets. You know what I mean? Like, I am, you know, it's just so, like, you know, once you find that person, you know, marry them. Marry that good person and stick with them, ride with them, because it's cold out there. Like, really. It's crazy out there, you know, like any, you know, I'm sure anyone who's single knows, like, yeah, it's fun for a little bit, but that shit gets so old, and, like, to really be out and about talking to, like, multiple people, like, who can be pillow talking, who can really spread out your business, people you don't really trust, people that just, especially now that with social media, people just can get clout off of, like, any tea that they get from you, it's, you really can't trust people for real, you know, like, you really just gonna be like, you know, so, and it's just, that's just what it is when you're single like that, you're out there, like, trying to meet people, and people got their own intentions, so I really felt this bar as a married man of, it's been 5 years now, like, it's nice over here, I'll tell you that, so I hope y'all, you know, take what he's saying for real. Like, it's okay to be in the house, you know, and it helps being in the house when you got, like, you don't gotta be, like, looking for somebody, like, all the time, you know. That's for most men, like, that's why we go out, like, you know what I mean, like, that's why we go out, like, it's like we looking for something new, you know what I mean, but, like, once you find that solid, like, hang on to them, you know what I mean, so
When I stayed inside of my house, you better off to having one woman. Everything tricky right now. You niggas live in denial. Ain't fuck anybody empathetic to the other side, I vow. A bitch nigga love bitch niggas. They exist with them in style. Exterminate them right now. Make
a bitch nigga love bitch niggas. Should be in the Bible. It's probably in the Bible. It's probably, that's probably written in the Bible. That's he probably literally just copy and pasted that from the Bible. Yeah, definitely.
A bitch nigga love bitch niggas. They exist with them in style. Exterminate them right now. Make Cat Williams and them proud. The truth about to get loud. No juices out of my cup. I sober up and knock them all off. Don't let no white comedian talk about no black woman as law. I know probably gonna work for them. And fuck whoever white comedian talk about no black woman as law.
Where the lyrics at, bro? No lyrics yet? There's gotta be lyrics, bro. Am I bugging? I don't know how to work this goddamn desktop file. Anyway, it sounded like he said, don't let no white comedian
talk about no black woman as law. I know
probably don't let no white comedian talk about a black woman that's law. He is talking about Andrew fucking Schultz, bro. And those two like Nigerian dudes who like just let Andrew Schultz make jokes about black women. And these guys like kind of didn't check him, you know. It's just like that conversation they were talking about black women, and I don't know, you know, ethnicity wise, like I don't know if they're talking about African women or black American women.
Glow up the other culture.
Yeah, so you'll see a guy who's had a black girlfriend, all of a sudden he's got buzz cut, like clean shape up.
They shave their hair because they start losing it. Because it's so stressed being around this black girl complaining about shit all the fucking time. That's why they got to shave their hair.
Nah, bro. White guys with black girlfriends, they
grow a beard because there's more cushion when they get slapped the fuck out of.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, these are conversations like that are more appropriate, like when it's like everyone's black and they can all like talk and it's not like embedded in racism. But Andrew Schultz, like, he was saying some really questionable shit. I'm going to find it. I'm going to try and put it in here. But that is a bar. That is truth. I never liked Andrew Schultz. I don't know why he just gives off, I don't know, man. It's just, like, you can see it, like, you can see it clear as day the dude is racist. But he likes to profit and benefit off of black culture. He's just one of those guys. You know, you know, and I really think he's like super racist behind closed doors. You know what I mean? He's one of those just those white comedians who just think that they can kind of mask behind it because like they can mask behind their comedy with racism, you know, in some way, or they can seem like, oh, I'm not racist, I'm just funny. Like, no, bro, you're a racist, you know. So allegedly, that's what I think he is. And the fact that he kind of kept egging these guys on and he was talking about whatever relationship he's been in or whatever. Like, I think he was like with some mixed girl or whatever. Regardless, like, you don't do that, you know? So, but these guys are two Nigerian dudes that was doing it. So I don't know what the hell, but anyway, Kendrick was talking about that. He's talking about that.
For them and fuck whoever that's close to them. The niggas that coon and niggas that beady and talk about no black woman as law. I know probably gonna work for them and fuck whoever that's close to them. The niggas that coon and niggas that being groomed. Slide on both of them. You ever eat Captain Crunch and
Basile? Yup, those guys, we can all agree we're coons. That's what we can all agree. Those two Nigerian guys who were like, you know, kiki and ha-haing like with Andrew Schultz. Like, it's coon behavior where like you let a white guy make jokes about black women. And you just kiki. No, you don't. You don't be like, bro, chill. Like, what the fuck? Like, who are you, bro? Like, who are you? You have no, you know, you don't do that. You know, you don't do that. Like, you know, so anyway, coons will allow that to happen.
Topo water in it, pulled over by the law. You ran dirty so you can argue with them to make it to be a star. Bear your soul and put your heart up in it. Well, I did. Whack the murals out, but it ain't no legends if my legend ends.
Man, that's whacked out murals. Whacked out murals. Murals. Good music. Good music. For real though, That song is hard as hell. Great intro. This is not Mr. Morale. This is more like Good Kid, Mad City, Kendrick. 100%. He's here. He's in his Black Air Forces. He ain't playing. This is a banger. Yeah, he's a menace. He's a menace right now. Yeah. So let me know what you guys think about that song. The next song is called Squabble Up. Yeah, I'm about to bump this shit.